Inspiration.
I can do anything.
Education.
Let's do this.
And application.
Oh boy, this is gonna be good.
Welcome to Like It Matters Radio, keeping us out of the water hazard with some truth therapy and teeing up solutions for today's big issues. Here's your life caddy, Mr. Scott V. Black.
So welcome to the world of Mr. Black.
You know the thing.
Welcome to the world of Mr. Black, and I am he. And as Mr. Biden said, you know the thing, and the thing is to be under construction on the Like It Matters radio network. We call it an hour of power. Why do we call an hour of power? Because we're working our noodle. We're working our noggin. The one organ in our body that has unlimited plasticity. In other words, it never needs to wear out is our brain. But like with every other organ, with every other muscle, there's something called atrophy. In other words, if you don't use it, you lose it. And boy, ladies and gentlemen, looking at America, looking at the news, I'm afraid we're losing it. Because I think it was Mark Levin, as Sean Hannity calls him, the great one, calls a bunch of drones, people who just are told what to think. We call them sheeple. Right? That's a blend of sheep and people, right? Yeah, sheeple. They just going along wherever the shepherd takes them. And boy, that's a different story, a different show, because everybody has a shepherd. Everybody's following somebody. Are you following the good shepherd or are you following the world shepherd? Because there's two totally different destinations, two total different paths. One is wide. A lot of people are on it, having a lot of fun. But the good book says it's leading to a place that you don't want to spend eternity, not even a day. And there's another road, another path that we've been told is narrow. We've been told that very few are on it. Matter of fact, we are actually told that very few can find it. And he said, seek that one. And he says it's hard. And that's what this is about. We want to get you to where you're in control. Remember, Dr. Viktor Frankl said between the stimulus and the response, there's a space. And in that space, you will find your power. You will find your freedom. And so today on Like It Matters Radio, we're going to talk about miscommunication. Nope, I did not say communication. I said miscommunication. See, communication is the foundation for a relationship, all relationships, both business and personal. And as human beings, we have so much information coming at us at all time. So we filter. We have natural filters. If not, I think the term would be autism. Let's get autism is all this stuff coming at you at one time, and the filters are shut off. The filters are shut off. And we have natural filters, deletions, distortions, generalizations. Now, I was reading a magazine, Fast Company. I haven't read it for years, but I was scanning some articles. And in there, I read the following statement. Quote, we've created a world with 300 exabytes. And I don't know what an exabyte is, but because I've never heard of it, I tell you, it's a lot. It's a lot. 300 exabytes of human-made information. And then it goes on to saying, yeah, attempt to process this, all that. I mean, how do you process all that information? And then with the issues of life, our trauma, our drama, think about that. See, we can't process that much information. So God gave us three natural filters. They're called distortions, they're called generalizations, and they're called deletions. And these filters are also the key to miscommunication. And there's a lot of miscommunication going on. And so today we're going to break that down because, you know, you got to make sure you're dealing with the right words at the right time. It always reminds me of a joke, you know, Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson were out camping. And so they pitched a tent under the stars and they went to sleep. Sometime in the middle of the night, Holmes woke up Watson and said, Watson, look up at the stars. Tell me, what do you see? And Watson replied, wow, it's beautiful. I see millions and millions of stars. Holmes said, okay, what do you deduce that you're laying in your sleeping bag and you're looking up at the sky and you're seeing millions and millions of stars? So Watson contemplated that. He said, well, if there are millions of stars, and even if a few of those have planets, it's quite likely there are some planets like Earth out there. And there are a few planets like Earth out there. There also might be life. And he goes into this long explanation. and Holmes interrupting, "Watson, Watson, you idiot. It means that someone stole our tent."
Logical. Brilliant.
Logical. Brilliant. You're right. And, you know, Sherlock Holmes, pretty smart guy. At least that's what is it, Sir Arthur Conan Doyle? Is that what the guy's name was that wrote it, right? So, ladies and gentlemen, we miscommunicate at all times. Sorry, I keep hitting the mic. I got a little mouthpiece on my headset. It keeps hitting my mic. So stop that. Stop that. So what we want to do today is show how we do these things, how we miscommunicate. And I always tell people, under the category of generalizations, there's another category we're going to talk about today called nominalizations. Because we misspeak all the time. Sometimes it's intentional. Some people manipulate us this way. But for a lot of us, it's accidental. And I always tell people in my training that at the very end, when they have a successful week, and I said, you know, this training is about success. And it's very important that you have to have a definition of success. And people ask me, why is that so important? And I say, because how do you know if you're on course or if you're off course? Right? If you don't have success defined, then how do you know if you're moving in the right direction? How do you know if you're moving in the wrong direction? How do you know if you're making any progress at all? Or how do you know if you're going backwards? You've got to define that word. And see, success falls under the category of generalization, but it falls into the subcategory of nominalization. And what makes a nominalization a nominalization is you cannot put it in a wheelbarrow. And there's a lot of words out there being thrown around that are nominalizations. You know, justice. We see it all the time. No justice, no peace. Social justice. You can't put social justice in a wheelbarrow. And I'm going to tell you right now, social justice to Jesus Christ is much different than social justice from Nancy Pelosi. Totally different. They're not even in the same hemisphere. They're not even in what the Catholic Church would call normal. I'm just telling you that right now. And so we gotta be aware of the words racist. You know, boy, that word's thrown around all the time. Words like homophobe and xenophobe, and yet most people don't even know what these words mean. But the word success is unique because if you line up 100 people all age 25 and ask them in 40 years at age 65 if they're going to be successful, every single one of them is going to affirm, yes, of course. Now, if you know the numbers, some 30-some people don't even make it that long. And then out of all the numbers, I think one is totally wealthy, can do whatever they want, and five can basically live a life that's not dependent on someone else's need. The others are either dead or dead broke, 95 of the 100. And so, ladies and gentlemen, success is important. You must define it. I know the success for this radio show is inspiration, education, application. If I'm doing a show that doesn't fit one of those three categories or all three of them, it has not been successful. But Ralph Waldo Emerson had a great, great definition of success. And here's what Ralph Waldo Emerson defined it as. Success, to laugh often and love much. To win the respect of intelligent persons and the affection of children. To earn the approbation of honest critics and endure the betrayal of false friends. To appreciate beauty. To find the best in others. To give of oneself. To leave the world a bit better, whether by a healthy child, a garden patch, or redeemed social condition. To have played and laughed with enthusiasm and sung with exaltation. To know even one life has breathed easier because you have lived. This is to truly have succeeded. So you got to know what your definition is. To some people, success might be a good marriage. For some, it might be a trophy spouse. For some, it might be 2.5 kids. For some, it might be owning an own business. But that word is self-defined, like so many other words out there. And so today on Like It Matters Radio, we're going to go through the concept of miscommunication because we're really good at it. And we've got to reverse engineer this thing to figure out how we got so good at miscommunicating. I'm Mr. Black. We'll be back.
Don't mess with me when it comes to words.
Communication. Just a little communication. If you see your brother falling down, give him a chance to make one more round.
Between the
stimulus and the response, there is a space, and in that space is your power, your freedom, Dr. Viktor Frankl. In this unprecedented time of pandemics and confusion, our daily choices matter more, and they are more consequential. Times of challenge and opportunities require another set of eyes, a deeper understanding, a bigger picture, so we can live a life of purpose and passion like it matters. Mr. Black is excited to announce the release of his newest book, Way of the Warrior, a daily devotional, bringing hope and encouragement to be all that you were created to be. Each day, Mr. Black shares with you guidance from above that is educational, inspirational, and applicational. Access Mr. Black each day as he continues to help you raise your bar and become all you were created to be. Way of the Warrior Daily Devotional is now available in ebook and hardcover at likeitmatters.net. Regain and retain your power and your freedom. Order Way of the Warrior Daily Devotional and let God be your guide and Mr. Black your life caddy. Order today at likeitmatters.net.
Whoa, look at all these options.
You could fill an entire warehouse with all the different ways you can stream Freedom 1570. Top shelf choices include freedom1570.com, our free app, and radio.com.
Alexa, how do I fix a circuit breaker that keeps tripping?
Yeah, that sounds like something to save for the professionals. You need to call Early Bird Electric. Their expertise is troubleshooting and rewires. They're offering a free service call with purchased repair. Get same-day service and a lifetime craftsmanship warranty. Early Bird Electric. Call
612-THE-BIRD. Early Bird Electric. 612-THE-BIRD.
Have you been charged with a gun crime? Have you lost your gun rights due to an old criminal offense? Have you been denied a permit to carry or a purchase of a firearm? I'm Attorney Kelly Keegan, and I can help. Contact us for a free consultation at KeeganLawOffice.com.
This is Scott Black of Like It Matters. As many of you know, I have been helping people to be the best they were created to be. COVID-19 has accelerated changes that I have been considering for some time now. Many more people need to receive the benefits of leadership awakening. Mental health in our communities is a real issue. We recently received our 501c3 nonprofit status with the emphasis of creating and delivering, taking back your power and your freedom to the least among us struggling with mental health issues. Please help us help others. You can save a marriage, save a business, or a life by supporting Like It Matters with your tax-deductible gifts. All gifts are needed, large, small, and everything in between. Please consider becoming a monthly partner at likeitmatters.net. Give today at likeitmatters.net. And by the way, Like It Matters Leadership Awakening classes will continue. Check out the schedule at likeitmatters.net as we build our training for those suffering from the challenges of poor mental health. God bless you.
I used to be with it, but then they changed what it was. Now what I'm with isn't it, and what's it seems weird and scary to me. It'll happen to you.
Oh yeah, welcome back to Like It Matters Radio. Radio, Like It Matters, inspiration, education, and application. That was such a great drop there by John. And that's what we're talking about. Today we're talking about miscommunicating well, because boy, have we mastered the art of miscommunication. And I want you to think about that statement I just made, mastering the art of miscommunication. Because I'm going to tell you, a lot of us do it at the unconscious level. We are poor communicators by trade. But I want you to know, there are many out there that are intentionally using this. See, I've talked about it all the time. You just got to study people like Joseph Goebbels, Saul Alinsky, Rules of Radicals. Read the book, The Power of Habit by Charles Duhigg. We're being played, player. We're being manipulated. Words are programming. You got to get this. Words are programming. How do you think you train an animal? Sit, run, stop, wait. Right? Words. And then those words are tied to actions. And any behavior reinforced with a positive outcome will repeat itself. And that positive outcome could be a dog treat. It could be sex. It could be a pat on the back. It could be recognition. But we are mere animals. Yeah. Just dolphins are trained. Monkeys are trained. Elephants are trained. Zoos do it all the time, right? Sheeple are trained. And so this is one of the things I'm talking about. You can believe what you want to believe. That's your right. That's your freedom. But you should always be able to give a reason for everything that you believe. And what's lacking in today's world is there is manipulation going on. And then whenever we question it, well, most of you don't question it. You're just sheeple. You just go along because Uncle Biden, Big Daddy Biden's going to take care of you, right? The government's going to take care of you because the government's our God, right? From the womb to the tomb, right? That's what they want. They call it socialism, call it Marxism, call it communism, call it humanism, whatever ism you want to use, but it ism going to be part of my life. I know that wasn't right, but it kind of sounded playful. So it ism going to be part of my life. Yeah, I know, John. If I have to beg for it, it just ain't worth it. But ladies and gentlemen, that's what's going on. And one thing we like to do here is pull back the curtain, right? Because there's a lot of things going on unconsciously that you're not aware of. And so, I mean, and we've been programmed. Perfect example. I'm on Facebook, and someone has sent a picture, and it was a picture with meaning, a cartoon, and it showed the Democratic Party embracing Islam, and Islam was a person, and then Islam had a noose around the neck of the Democrat person because they're embracing Islam. And the sad part about it is true, pure Islam. I studied the Quran. I have 3 copies of it, the Quran in English and the Injil as well. So I study it. But, man, I'll tell you, it's manipulation. And if we're going to talk about it, if they were true Muslims in a Muslim country like Pakistan or Saudi Arabia, a lot of people in the Democratic Party would be in prison, would be killed, Islam is against a lot of the platform of the Democratic Party. And so it makes no sense. And so anyway, someone put this picture out there, and then I forwarded it, and I said, so tell me your thoughts. Tell me your thoughts. And then I added a note, and I said, just to be fair, I studied the Quran. I've shared the gospel of Jesus Christ with many Muslims. I've studied with Muslims for years. So just in all full disclosure, I wanted people to know that this wasn't an attack on Muslims or this wasn't a pro-Muslim thing. I was honestly asking people's questions. And this one dude came in there and just went off. I mean, F this, F that. You think they're going to come and take our country, whatever? And then the very end, he puts in capital letters, and I'm gonna abbreviate it, but you can know it's F Trump. And I'm like, what does Donald Trump have to do with this? And there was no mention of Donald Trump. It had nothing to do with Donald Trump. Okay. It was no article about Donald Trump. It was talking about Muslims and what the Democratic Party is doing. The one religion that they will embrace is Islam, the Democratic Party, right? You can't pray to the name of Jesus Christ. They don't want the Bible used in Congress. But the other day, to open a session of Congress, they had a Muslim praying. They're fine with that. And so it's just interesting. And this is where the programming comes from. This is where all the programming. And this is where you got to understand what's going on. And so from WillWilliams.com of the UK, because he's an NLP guy like I am, he has this great little article called Generalizations, Deletions, and Distortions. He says negative vague language can work for you or against you. See, here's the problem. They're using it against you, but I use it to help people. I'm a master in neurolinguistic programming. My leadership training, you hear from people once a month that have been through my training, and it changes their lives. And a lot of it is I have to go into the programming, the negative programming that's been in place. Remember, by the time a child is 6 years old, the majority of their map of reality is in place, their basic structure of the belief systems. And so you got to realize that this can be used constructively in a manipulative way to help people. In NLP, there are two language patterns. There's a meta language pattern, and there's the Milton language pattern. Milton is more vague, more open. So if I'm taking someone on a guided meditation or a guided journey, if I'm working on their subconscious mind, I want to let their subconscious mind fill in the blanks. And so to keep rapport, to maintain that rapport that I established early on, I will speak in vagueness so that they can fill in their own blanks based on their own experience. However, if I want to deal with someone's trauma and drama, and I want to deal with someone's negative belief systems, if I want to deal with a reprogramming, taking off some of the negative programming that was beaten into them as childhood or as a young adult or an abusive relationship, then I'm going to use a meta pattern, which will dig down. And what happens when you're going through these deletions, distortions, generalization, the only way to really get the information you're looking for is through the meta language. And so you got to realize these deletions, distortions, generalizations, we leave out information for a purpose. Whether we're talking about self-talk or dialogue with others, generalizations that we make, they allow for details to be left out. The way we distort through language influences how we think, feel, and act. So you can choose limiting vague language or artfully vague language patterns that are positive and empowering. It works. I'm telling you, I've done it for years. I'm a master practitioner. I see the impact of generalization, deletion, and distortions every day. I've long been a fan of shaping language, right? I'm an etymologist by trade, and I listen to people. One thing that's really annoying, and people hate that, I actually listen to what they say. If you ever go through my training, and you can go to likeitmatters.net, likeitmatters.net, and read about my transformational training, because a lot of people are totally unaware. Remember, we only use 3 to 5% of our brain consciously. However, we're using all of our brain. The rest is, unfortunately, at the unconscious level. And a lot of its programming is through our words, and words can inspire or they can cut you down. And the language choice exemplifies our values, our beliefs. By paying attention to our language choice and the language of others, we can learn the underlying values and beliefs. And that's what's going on. See, what's lacking today is understanding. If I can understand you a little bit better, and you can understand me a little bit better, doesn't make sense we're in a position of a better relationship. See, we can use language to be empowering or disempowering. Generalizations, deletions, distortions, they can work for or against us. We got to learn to pay attention to how our language and the language of others has an impact on what we're doing, our thinking, our feeling, all the time. I mean, take any married couple. Those deletions, distortions, generalizations, things that we leave out cause a lot of problem. Think about when you text somebody. Remember, words are about 7% of communication. So all you're doing is sending words. So where's the other 93% coming in? The other 93% is coming in through how that person's day went, what they're dealing with right now, the history of your relationship. So they're reading information into it, information that was not presented. They fill in the blanks. And here's what we're talking about. The definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over, right? It's crazy. So you got to change your approach. If you don't like the results, change your approach. As you change your approach, you change the results. So if you want better results, we got to start by changing our language. Our language impacts how we think, feel, and behave. And we have choices over our language. If we change our language, we change our results, right? That's what you got to get. So generalization is where the speaker takes a particular experience, applies it generically to a multitude of other ones. So like an example, you can't run a family and work full time. That's a generalization. Children need discipline. Nobody loves me. And by the way, you can tell when people are generalizing because you'll hear these words, can't, unable, not possible, need, must have, right? Necessary requirement, right? Everybody, nobody, anybody. And by the way, these are also words to tell you if someone's in a victim mode. Nobody ever loves me. Everybody always disrespects me. It never works out that way. Whenever anybody's using those words, those universal quantifiers, I think they're called universal quantifiers, everybody, nobody, anyone, everyone, always, never, beware, that person is coming from a victim mode. And one of the best ways to negate it is to restate the question. Never? Oh, no one's ever treated me nice. Never? No one, not a single person ever? Never you've had a good experience with your mom? Never you've had a good experience with a person? Sometimes. Oh, so sometimes. And you got to actually go in there and reprogram it because it's coming. Nobody's ever complimented me. Nobody? Never once? Never once, you've never given anybody anything and they thank you or told you, never what. See, you've got to question it and challenge it. The problem is today, if you don't agree with the sheeple, the narrative, they ban you. They restrict you. So today on Like It Matters Radio, we're talking about how we are such gifted miscommunicators. We'll be right back.
We all wear masks, metaphorically speaking.
Way of the future. Way of the future. The way of the future.
What can you do in 48 hours that changes your life? Like It Matters Leadership Awakening. Listen to this 22-year law enforcement veteran with PTSD compare Leadership Awakening to other training he's received.
You focus on the individual. I think you kind of answered the why question, whereas a lot of the other programs that are out there, I don't want to say they put a Band-Aid on it, but they don't do a very good job of going into the why. And, you know, why am I doing this? Why is my brain revert back to the images? You know, why do I get depressed? And like you said, right, it's a choice.
48 hours. Give Mr. Black and Leadership Awakening just 48 hours, and it will change the course of your life. Go to likeitmatters.net and click on Schedule for Leadership Awakening near you. That's likeitmatters.net. Just click on Schedule. Leadership Awakening, where 48 hours will change your life.
Have you been suffering from numbness, tingling, burning, or restless pain in your hands or feet? It may be time to pivot from the cycle of more and more medications and take a conservative, holistic approach to your neuropathy. Get answers today by contacting Dr. Knight Chiropractor at Abundant Life Chiropractic Health Center in Chanhassen. If you do nothing, you run the risk of suffering long-term complications like infections, poor wound healing, balance issues restraining you to a walker, and possible amputations. In fact, 73,000 Americans lose a limb every year to untreated diabetic neuropathy. Get your life back today. Abundant Life Chiropractic Health Center has helped hundreds of patients improve and in some cases completely reverse their neuropathy. If you're ready to regain your independence, contact Dr. Knight DC at Abundant Life Chiropractic Health Center in Chanhassen. As a Freedom 1570 listener, you receive a special $49 Get Acquainted offer. That's a massive value for just $49. Neuropathy doesn't wait around. You shouldn't either. Call 952-300-8338 to schedule a full neuropathy workup.
This is Scott Black of Like It Matters. As many of you know, I have been helping people to be the best they were created to be. COVID-19 has accelerated changes that I have been considering for some time now. Many more people need to receive the benefits of Leadership Awakening. Mental health in our communities is a real issue. We recently received our 501c3 nonprofit status with the emphasis of creating and delivering, taking back your power and your freedom to the least among us struggling with mental health issues. Please help us help others. You can save a marriage, save a business, or a life by supporting Like It Matters with your tax-deductible gifts. All gifts are needed, large, small, and everything in between. Please consider becoming a monthly partner at likeitmatters.net. Give today at likeitmatters.net. And by the way, Like It Matters Leadership Awakening classes will continue. Check out the schedule at likeitmatters.net as we build our training for those suffering from the challenges of poor mental health. God bless you.
Let me hear that again.
Well, if beauty was only knee skin deep, I could take some of the money and I could have her skinned and then she'd be able to look at a clock without having to work hard anymore. Then we could settle down and I could scrape her chin and congenial if I didn't have to work hard anymore.
That's a good idea.
Welcome back to Like It Matters Radio, and that's what we're doing. We're sitting down and we're talking this thing over. Well, maybe you're moving, maybe you're working out, maybe you're driving your car, but we're just talking about stuff. See, ladies and gentlemen, this is about inspiration, education, and application, an hour of power. And by education, I do not mean that in an I'm smarter than you condescending way. I'm not talking about learning mere figures and facts so that you can be impressive when you go on the game show Jeopardy. What I'm talking about is training your mind to think. And I listen to people. And a good leader listens. Matter of fact, the good book tells us, men, to love our wives like Christ loved the church. And men, if you don't know what that means even when they're not lovable. Yep, because remember, God said, like Christ loved the church. But it's interesting because women are given a different statement. Women are told to respect their husbands. And ladies, if you're interested to know why the difference from God the Father, the creator of all things, because he knows us. And because God knows what most other men know in this one regard, that to a man, respect is love. Respect is love. You cannot disrespect a man and then tell him you love him. Because what you're doing speaks so loudly that people aren't listening to a word you're saying. And so one of the biggest ways we disrespect people is we don't listen to them. Even our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, said that. He said, why do you call me Lord, Lord, and not do what I say? He says, if you love me, you'd keep my commandments. And Jesus was in a house. I forgot where he was, but he was making things a little uncomfortable, and it was getting a little edgy in there, and somebody left the house party and went out to Jesus' home and told Mary and his brothers that, man, Jesus, you got to come get Jesus because he's freaking people out. He's claiming to be God. I'm paraphrasing and making up that part of the story. The Bible doesn't tell us what happened. But at some point, there's a knock on the door. And somebody comes up to Jesus and says, oh, God, this is how I think it happened. You know, paraphrasing. Oh, God, you know, sarcastically, your mother and your brother is outside for you. And Jesus' response was so powerful. He says, who is my mother? Who is my brother? But he or she who does the will of my Father, that is my mother, and that is my brother. Don't you hear what he's saying? My mother and my brother are those who listen to me. My mother and my brother are those who listen to God the Father. Again, it goes back to that issue of respect. And what's going on today is most people aren't listening to each other. We're in more meetings than ever. I was talking to a good friend of mine, Jeremy, a graduate, and said this morning, I called him like at 7:30. I said, Jeremy, I got to get a hold of you before your meetings. Because I remember years, Coca-Cola, I was did a lot of work with Coca-Cola when they were coming out with Dasani, the water bottle. And they spent years just designing that bottle. What was the right color to do? What was the right? Because, again, knowing how the unconscious mind works. And if you ever seen a Dasani water bottle, that blue, they spent a lot of money, a lot of time figuring out that was the perfect blue, because that blue at the unconscious level triggers purity, triggers tranquility, triggers clear, fresh water. It actually makes me thirsty thinking about it right now. I don't know about you, John. I'm getting thirsty because I'm just talking about that water, talking about the blueness. And so you got to realize that there's a lot going on, but you can't tell unless you're listening to people. And so I do a lot of one-on-one work, life counseling work. And Sunday, I wound up in Dallas. It was 8 o'clock meeting, a son and a father of who I work with. There had to be a real tough conversation take place. There's a new business deal going on, and they're getting a lot of flack, and there's not a lot of good communication going on between the father and the son. And so I'm sitting there as just a buffer. I'm kind of guiding conversation. You know, we were there for like 3 hours, and I probably spoke for 10% of the time. Good job if I'm doing good life caddy work. I'm guiding a conversation. I'm kind of the referee, if you will, but I'm not talking. I'm letting them talk. And so as we're doing all this, 3 hours, you know, all that, and then at the end, the guy who's my friend, I'll just call him Julio, told me a story about what had happened that day. And he probably took 20 minutes to tell this story, and there's everything else going on, so much other stuff going on. And so when I left, Julio had asked me, hey, do me a favor, I want to send a letter out to this restaurant that I told you the whole story about what happened. Would you go ahead and write it for me because you're really good, and then send it to me, and then I want to send it out to a couple people. Now, I'm a great listener, and I think Julio was blown away. Matter of fact, when I sent him a copy of the letter, the first draft of it, he sent me a three pages typed out. Explanation, because I wanted all the details. But I'm going to tell you right now, I could recall all the details. With everything else going on, I was prepared for this meeting. I had a lot of trauma and drama I was dealing with. My kids weren't home. I left my family to come be here to help these two guys because everything's on the line for them. And yet I could recite all the details of what he told me because I'm a good listener. People think I read people's mind. As a counselor, I learned a long time ago that I listen to what people are saying. I listen to what they're not saying. I watch their eyes when they're talking because it tells me where they're coming from. Are they visual? Are they auditory? Are they kinesthetic? It tells me if they're coming from memory or creativity. Are they making something up or are they recollecting? I'm not looking for emotion because everything important that happens to us arouses emotion. So if there's a point where someone gets really emotional, what were they just saying when they got emotional or what were they preparing to say as they got emotional? See, all that tells me information. Why? Because people naturally have three filters: generalizations, deletions, and distortions. Again, a generalization is where the speaker takes a particular experience and applies it. You know, all women are this way, right? I mean, someone's been with three women, and yet they're going to say all women. Or I love it when you get your liberal white friends, or former friends, liberal white former friends. I remember Joe, this guy said, well, you know, his daughter, Crystal, got him all into the whole BLM movement, all into critical race theory, all into black people are victims and white people are persecutors and all that. And I'll never forget what Joe said. Joe said, well, I talked to black people and they said they shared their experience. And now I know the pain that they've been through. And I'm thinking Joe probably knows five black people. And so I guarantee you he didn't talk to all five black people he knows. But interesting, notice I've talked to all black people think this way. Oh my gosh, I got so many friends who are black and conservative, and they think the whole BLM movement is a farce. They're insulted that you think I'm so weak that I need a white guy to help me out, that I can't make it on my own. I mean, these are millionaires. These are successful business owners. These are men and women that have incredible families, incredible jobs, and they just happen to be black. They're not victims. They're not, but it amazed me, but we use these terms all the time. Now, that's a generalization. So a distortion. I'm turning page here. Deletion. Deletion is where the details are deleted as the speaker chooses what to focus on. Like, he's a failure. Her children are not very bright. She rejected me. They were left to fend for themselves, right? And see, you got to listen for words. Instances where a verb has been turned into a noun, such as failing at becomes failure, right? Or he's performing becomes his performance, or he is succeeding becomes his success. Those which require an opposite, such as good, bad, cold, hot, bright, dull, insincere, happy, sad, rich, poor, verbs which require clarification. Non-specific references to people, things such as they, people, computers, children. When I was a little kid, I remember my dad used to get so mad whenever I'd refer to my mom as she or her. I mean, he would slap me in the face. Who's her? Who's she? And now that was abusive and all that. But his point was valid. You know, when I talked about my mom, my dad, it was always mom said this or my dad said this. He was offended if I put a pronoun there because I could be talking about any her or any she. And that's where we talk about deletion, something left out. And then I learned to ask meta questions, which I'm not going to go into that with you because that's not what this is about. This is not a therapy session. But I ask those questions to uncover that. And then the third one is distortions. And a distortion is when the speaker distorts something to mean something it was not intended to mean. So he like something like, he never buys me flowers, so he doesn't love me. See how we connect those? My children are driving me crazy. Or how about this one? You're killing me. I know you don't want to support my initiative. Families should stick together through all life's challenges, right? So we got to, again, listen. You got to be listening. Listens for statements that don't add up. You know, where a conclusion stated in the second part is based on the meaning attached in the first part. Statements in which one thing causes another, an if-then, a conditional statement. Statements which include conjecture or suggest mind reading. And a lot of people think I read their minds. And by the way, another one, which is a big one today, statements lacking reference to the author. Authority. One thing I hate about Facebook and social media is all opinions have equal weight. You can have someone who knows nothing about a subject, ignorant, purely ignorant, and they're going ahead and give their opinion. It has the same weight as a, quote, expert. And boy, it comes in handy when you talk about this vaccination that was going on. Boy, there's a lot of generalizations. There's a lot of little deletions, distortions. anything to do with politics right now, deletions, distortions, generalization. Anything to do with COVID-19, deletions, distortions, generalization. Anything that goes against the corporate narrative of the deep state, deletions, generalizations, and distortions. I'm Mr. Black. We'll be right back.
All in the construction business, constructing memories, relationships, new ideas, and a legacy that will outlive us. Life is best imagined as a construction project.
Hey, can we get that backhoe over here?
At Like It Matters, we craft tools and teach you how to use them. Mr. Black has a bevy of tools to help you build your life into your dream. One of those tools is individual life counseling. The best analogy is a life caddy, because sometimes you just need another set of eyes. A second tool, books by Mr. Black, always opening up your mind. Third, workshops, where we teach people how they work and how to function at a higher level. And don't forget the daily radio show, Like It Matters, at 11 a.m. on Freedom 1570.
Nice job. That's it for today. Wrap it up.
Contact Mr. Black at mr.black@likeitmatters.net. Building a better you today. Likeitmatters.net. Helping people live their lives like they matter. That's mr.black@likeitmatters.net. Discover the tools to build your relationships, your vision, and your life.
Cool voiceover. Zany sound effect.
Okay, we were going to write a flashy promo about streaming us on radio.com. But considering how easy it is to do, we'll just keep it simple, too. Listen to Freedom 1570 on the radio.com app.
Get that Rack Shack attack, Rack Shack barbecue. To do you right, we take time for a barbecue.
Hey, it's Lee Michaels here for the Minnesota Horse and Hunt Club in Prior Lake. The Horse and Hunt Club is one of the premier sporting facilities in the world. Memberships are available, but sporting clays are open to the public. And don't forget to stop by Triggers for lunch or dinner. Visit horseandhunt.com.
When I attended the Leadership Awakening workshop, I didn't know what to expect, but I was open. The tools taught at Leadership Awakening helped me discover things about myself that were holding me back from being all God created me to be. Providential? That word coins these life-changing classes because I now realize there are works God has already created for me to walk in, and these workshops helped me to see this more clearly. I received practical insights that I am already applying to be a more focused businesswoman, influential mom to my two teenagers, an 8.5-year-old son, and patient and impactful. Passionate wife. I got rid of a lot of clutter in my head. BS, they call it, belief systems that were not serving me. If you want to know what it means to empower others instead of trying to control them, if you want to build a productive team in 2 days, if you want to press the reset button in your life and give yourself a fresh new beginning, then do yourself and your family a favor and attend the next Leadership Awakening. It's time the giant in you comes alive.
Leadership Awakening is coming to a location near you. Details at likeitmatters.net. That's likeitmatters.net.
First of all, we must internalize the flatulation of the matter by transmitting the effervescence of the Indonesian proximity in order to further segregate the crux of my venereal infection. Now, if I may retain my liquids here for one moment.
Express yourself.
Welcome back to Like It Matters Radio, where we're helping you express yourself. Because you know what, ladies and gentlemen? Miscommunication is everywhere. Boy, we are so good at miscommunicating. You would think that we're going to school for it. And up until now, we've been talking about the three filters that allow us to actually manipulate, allow us to move people, but it also allows us to miscommunicate. And those are deletions, distortions, generalizations. But now I want to add a last subject I want to add to this, and that's really about words. You know, we use words. That's why I love the thing with Damon Wayans from Living Color, where he's just throwing around words, but acting like he knows what they mean, and we laugh. But have you seen our government lately? They're doing the same exact thing. Same exact thing. You know, on the break, I saw a joke. I'm on Mr. Jokes, MrJokes.com. And it said, I just spotted an albino Dalmatian. It was the least I could do. And I had to like, what? I just spotted an albino Dalmatian, .. It was the least I could do. And that really goes, yeah, it was the least I could do. I get it now. See, but here you go, spotted, right? There's that word spotted. Notice the dual meaning, right? Spotted, a Dalmatian is a spotted animal. It has spots on it. Spotted also mean to put in your visual sight, to make a connection visually, right? So I just spotted an albino Dalmatian. It was the least I could do. Again, double meaning there on the least, if you think about it. And this is what happens all the time. There's double talk. There's people using words in the wrong way. And not only that, there are anchors. Man, I was looking at the news, and I'm not a big fan of any of the TV and the talk shows. But I guess there's this woman, Ozzy Osbourne's wife, Sharon Osbourne. She's on a talk show, The Talk, I think it's called, or something like that. And Piers Morgan was just attacked as being racist. Why? Because that beautiful white-looking woman called Meghan Markle, she's black, I guess. I mean, one of her parents is black. I'm browner than she is, I think. But, I mean, she's a princess. She's a movie star. She got hundreds of million people watched her get married. She lives in a castle. But, yeah, she's a victim. And what's the victim? Racism. She's a victim of racism because people treat her poorly because she's black. Now, have you seen a picture of Meghan Markle? So anyway, so Piers Morgan, who's never been a big fan, I mean, here's an American victim. If anybody knows her, if you read about her, she's all about drama. And now you see the Democratic Party wants to run her for president, wants to run her for national office. Why? Because she's a famous victim. Wow. And so, boy, we love famous victims today. And so, man, they can write their own ticket. You know, we used to believe that the best way to get whatever you want in life is to work hard, to overcome adversity, to save up money, to make better choices. Nope, none of that's true anymore. In Joe Biden's America, in America 2021, if you want to get everything that you want, you become offended. You show how you're a victim. And once you can do that, especially if it's against Trump or against white people or against conservative people or Christians, you will have a ticket to ride to ultimate fame. I mean, it's incredible. Not a joke. The sad part, it is a joke because it's not a joke. That's the bad part. But you look at just words. You know, you got to make sure you're using the right word the right way. You know, there are a lot of words in the English dictionary that have multiple meanings. Multiple meanings. Matter of fact, the most defined word in the English dictionary, if you want to look it up, at least it was for a while, might be something different now, but is the word set. S-E-T. Set. Three letters. About 400 variations, uses of that word. Look it up. 400. But we do this all the time. We throw around a word love. You know, when I do counseling, you have a couple ready for divorce. And one of them says, well, if he loved me, he'd do this. And then she says, well, yeah. I mean, he says, well, yeah, she loved me, she'd do this. And then she says, oh, yeah? Well, if you love me, you'd do this. And you know that dance. If you've been married for more than 2 months, you know that dance. And so I would go up to client A and say, Mr. Client, what do you need from your wife to experience love? Tell us out loud. And then I would look at Miss Wife and say, are you willing to do that? And then I would look at Miss Wife and say, tell your husband, what do you need to experience love? Tell us out loud. And then she says that, then I ask Mr. Husband, are you willing to do that? Yep. Thank you, guys. Have a great life. I wish you well. See, I don't need to see someone for 5 years to buy me a new boat. If you're going to the same therapist, counselor, for a long, long, long time, and they're not just helping you live your life, you're still dealing with the past, you need to fire that person and get someone else because you're just buying them stuff. That's all you're doing. And you might like to buy them stuff, but you got to realize that we can fix ourselves. We just got to realize what's going on. And so the word love, I mean, think about the love. I love chocolate pudding. I love my wife. I love my Lord, my Savior, with all my heart, with all my body, with all my strength. I love my little black cat, Susan, right? You know this. I've said this before. But I better love my wife. better than I love Rocky Road ice cream. And I better love my Lord better than I love my wife. And even in the Bible, there are four Greek words, because remember, the New Testament is written in Greek. It was the language of the day. That can be translated to love. Eros, which is sexual love, which is not in the Bible. You know, agape, which is godly love, unconditional love. You have phileo, which is brotherly love. And then you have a compound word called storge, S-T-O-R-G-E. And that's a compound word, but it's familial love. But yet it's translated as love. In the Bible, the word time, same thing with time. You know, time is two Greek words, chronos and kairos. Chronos is the time on your watch, time on the sundial, the time that you see when you look at your phone. That is chronos. It's specific. But kairos is a space and time, the times that we're in. Ecclesiastes 3, there's a time to plant and a time to harvest, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for love and a time for war, whatever that is, right? They're talking about kairos. And if you've been married, you know, when your spouse looks at you a certain way or says a certain thing, you know that it's time for some good time, right? And you also know, if you've been married for a while, that if your spouse looks a certain way or says something, then it's time that you got some splaining to do, right? See, that's what the Greek word kairos means. There's a time. We are now biblically, if you, eschatologically, in the prophetic Bible, if you will, we are in what's called the time of the Gentiles. Remember, the Jews made Jesus a stumble block. They crucified Christ, and so they're basically separate. They're on time out from God right now. But the Jews are still God's people. Right now we're in the time of the Gentiles. So God focused on the Gentiles, the non-Jews, to engraft them. He basically adopted us. Why? So the gospel's open to everybody, but the Bible says there's a reason to make the Jews jealous. And then once we're done with the time of the Gentiles and the last Gentile has been activated, then the Bible says eschatologically that we then go into the time of Jacob's trouble, which is the time that you've heard as the Great Tribulation. And it's during that time that God will then deal with the curse on this earth, the curse on man, and deal with the Jews who have been separate from him since they crucified Christ. And then he will bring them back in the fold. And that's what in book Revelation, they talk about the 144,000. And so all this to tell you, we've got to make sure that we're using the right words at the right time, the right way. And the one way you got to do it is to live in the now moment. So many people are living in the past, right? We live in a world that's telling you regret, resent, and resist. The problem is your mind is six times faster than you can talk. And so when someone says something or does something, you don't respond to what they're doing. You then go to your channels. You go to the visual channel. You see something from your past. You go to the auditory channel. You hear something or say something about your past. Or you go to the kinesthetic channel where you feel something either tactilely or emotionally about the past. And then you respond. See, you're not responding to what people are saying or doing. You're responding to your narrative. But the first thing is we need to listen to each other. It's because what's lacking today is understanding. And if I can walk a mile in your moccasins, that's called empathy, then I can understand you a little bit better. And if I can understand you a little bit better, and you can understand me a little bit better, doesn't it make sense we're in a position to have a better relationship? Yes. And look up the word vaccination. By the CDC standards, vaccinations defined, what they're giving out, COVID-19 vaccination, is not a vaccination. It's therapy. You need to look at it. Look up luciferase. Look up hydrogel. Look up all the stuff. See, we should be allowed to question things. And what's being removed from us, the ability to question things. But you'll always get on this radio show. So tune in for an hour a day from Monday through Friday from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. Central Standard Time. I am Mr. Black. Talk tomorrow, reminding you that when you live your life like it matters, it does.
All across the nation, we are here for our communities.
We're doing our part to get supplies where it's needed in order to fight COVID-19 together.
Got to do what we got to do, helping the people that did lose their jobs and lost their income and now they don't have money for their food.
It feels good to be out there to assist our community with what we're dealing with. It's what you sign up for as a soldier.
We will not rest until the mission is complete.
Each one of these soldiers, once they received the call, they understood that all hands were on deck. This goes to the core of what citizen soldiers do.
We are your Army National Guard.
I would like our friends and family to know that your National Guardsmen are always ready and always there.
Always ready, always there. Visit NationalGuard.com to find out more. Sponsored by the Minnesota Army National Guard. Aired by the Minnesota Broadcasters Association and this station.